it's Jacob from New York City. Today I want to talk about how you think about and define the word leader. And this is something that I talk about in my new book, The Future Leader. And I've been giving a couple talks based on my new book to a couple different organizations. And one of the things that I always like to ask the attendees to do at the beginning of my talks is to take out a sheet of paper. And on that sheet of paper, I ask them to define the word leader and to give a couple examples of who they think is a great leader that they want to look up to, somebody who they want to emulate. And I've noticed a couple of very, very distinct differences, and I'm not gonna call out any specific organizations here, but I have noticed that in some organizations, when I ask them to define the word leader, they will typically give definitions that are very centered around results, business metrics, ROI, achieving success, becoming number one, you know, those types of things. And the types of leaders that they look up to are people like Jeff Bezos, Elon Musk, you know, they typically mention a lot of business leaders. And then I've also noticed that there are other organizations. And when I ask them to define the word leader, they talk about somebody who others trust, caring, somebody who's compassionate, guiding others, somebody who is helping create a vision and guiding other people along that vision, you know, toward that journey. And the definitions are very, very different. Some are very, very focused on the business results, the ROI stuff, and others are very focused on the human stuff, right? Trust, caring, the coach, somebody who has your back. And when I ask those organizations who's a leader that they look up to, they give me people like their parents. They give me people like historical figures. They might mention somebody like an Abraham Lincoln, a Rosa Parks, right? It's just the way that they think about leadership is fundamentally different. And I notice that when I go into these different types of organizations, the culture is also very different, right? In the organizations that are very focused on the ROI, the business results and metrics, you get a different vibe. It's typically a little bit more conservative. It's more, you know, go, 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 nonstop. You look at the reviews of some of these companies on Glassdoor, they're lower. The CEO approval ratings are lower. They didn't score as high in my employee experience index. Employees are a little bit more burned out, stressed out. Whereas in these other types of organizations that define leader in kind of that more of a human way, they tend to be a little bit more happier, engaged. Those organizations are also successful and profitable as well. Now, in these organizations over here, the ones that define the word leader in terms of ROI and business metrics and success, when I ask them who they think a leader is, the people who they define as a leader are people who they've never met, right? Jeff Bezos, Elon Musk, you know, those types of CEOs and leaders. They've never met those people. Yet they believe that they are great leaders simply because they have created successful businesses. And so is that how we should be thinking about a leader? Is a leader somebody who just creates a successful business? What if that leader treats employees poorly? What if that leader runs an organization that is causing harm to the environment? What if that leader doesn't believe in fighting for social causes? Is that person still a leader? And so I think it's really, really important for us to think about how do we define the word leader and who are people that we look up to and emulate and want to respect and be like. So that's kind of an exercise I want you to think about doing. Define the word leader, write it down on a sheet of paper, encourage your teams to do this as well. And then put some names down for who you and your team think are leaders that you would like to look up to and emulate. And then compare the responses. See how you each define the word leader. See if you think about different types of people as leaders. And then in other videos, I'm going to talk about why that is so crucial as far as the filters that we create. Because the way that you define leader and the people that you look up to and want to emulate, ultimately that's going to create the kind of environment, the kind of culture for your organization. So the way that you think about leadership, the way that you define the word leader is going to set the direction for your company and for your team. And as we saw in these two different types of organizations that I've been seeing, one are very focused on the business results, the ROI, you know, the traditional business leaders, and the others I think are becoming a little bit more progressive and forward thinking. It doesn't mean that they don't value business results and ROI and objectives, but it's not the primary way that they use to define who a leader is and what a leader is and the types of people who they believe are future leaders. So do that exercise and let me know what comes out of it.